here at Broken Arrow Nursery on February 10th, visiting with Adam Wheeler, who's the propagation manager. So will you show us a little bit about the grafting techniques that you do?
Yeah, absolutely. I'm happy to do it. We do it all in the barn here. We can head on in and I'll show you what to do.
Great. Thank you. Yeah, so what are we looking at here?
Well, I'm working with some ginkgos today, and what I've got is some rootstock that we're going to be using here. These are just seedling ginkgos. They're probably about 3 years old. Mm-hmm. And this is what makes the root system of the graft combination. And then I've gone out in our collection of plants, and I collected some cuttings from one of the ginkgos that we're looking to propagate. This is a stem section from a variegated ginkgo, one with kind of gold streaks to the foliage. And this is called the scion, and it's what we're going to use in the graft combination. This is what's going to become the branch structure in the top part of the graft combination. The type of technique I'm using today is called a side veneer graft, and it's when we make a cut in the side of the rootstock with our grafting knife. And essentially all you're doing is making a flap-like cut about 3/4 of an inch long into the side of the rootstock. You can see that flap. And we're going to make a wedge-type cut in the base of the scion to match the flap cut in the rootstock. And the sides of the cut are approximately the same length as the flap cut I made in the rootstock. Yep, so you cut the base of the scion into a wedge, and then the scion gets inserted into that flap-like cut. And then the whole wound gets wrapped with one of these rubber bands, which helps secure it in place. This would typically be potted up and brought into a warm greenhouse and maintained in some sort of high humidity atmosphere in a fog tent, where the humidity and the heat is going to help drive the whole healing process. And what you're looking for is the vascular network of the rootstock to kind of align with the vascular network of the scion, and that's what links the ability of that scion to pull nutrients and moisture from the rootstock. And that happens best in a humid, warm environment, like around 70 degrees in a heated greenhouse.